and see that. What's the matter with them?
Don't know. Perhaps they've got flu.
Flu? Flu? They've been eating too much fresh fruit. Right, now, self-defense. Tonight I should be carrying on from where I got to last week. What I was showing you, how to defend yourself against anyone who attacks you armed with a piece of fresh fruit.
You promised we wouldn't do fruit this week.
What do you mean?
Well, we've done fresh fruit for the last 9 weeks.
What's wrong with fruit? You think you know it all, eh? Well,
can't we do something else for a change?
Like someone who attacks you with a pointed stick.
Pointed sticks?
Oh, we want to learn how to defend ourselves against pointed sticks, do we? Getting all iron mighty, eh? Fresh fruit not good enough for you, eh? Oh.
Well, I'll tell you something, my lad. When you're all walking home tonight and some homicidal maniac comes after you with a bunch of loganberries, don't come crying to me! Right, the passion fruit! When your assailant lunges at you with the passion fruit, thus...
We've done the passion fruit.
What?
We've done the passion fruit.
We've done oranges, apples, grapefruits...
Whole and segments.
Pomegranates, greengages...
Grapes, passion fruits...
Lemons...
Plums...
Yeah, and mangoes in syrup.
How about cherries?
We've done them.
Red and black?
Yes.
All right, then. Bananas! Oh. We haven't done them, have we? Oh. Right! Bananas! How do you defend yourself against a man armed with a banana? Yeah, you, take this. Now, it's quite simple to defend yourself against the banana fiend. First of all, you force him to drop the banana. Next, you eat the banana, thus disarming him. You have now rendered him helpless.
Suppose he's got a bunch.
Shut up!
Supposing he's got a pointed stick.
Shut up! Right, now! You, Mr. Apricot!
Harrison.
Mr. Harrison, come with me with that banana, then. Come on, attack me with it. As hard as you like. Come on. Come. No. Put something into it, for God's sake. Hold it like that. Scream. Now, come on. Come on, attack me. Come on. Come on. Come on. Yeah.
He's dead. You shot him.
I've now eaten the banana. The deceased Mr. Apricot is now disarmed.
You shot him dead.
Well, he was attacking me with a banana.
Well, you told him to.
No, I'm only doing my job. I have to show you how to defend yourself against fresh fruit.
And pointed sticks.
Shut up.
Supposing someone come at you with a banana and you haven't got a gun.
Run for it!
Oh, you couldn't stand and scream for help.
Yeah, you try that with a pineapple down your windpipe.
Pineapple?
Well,
I was just saying pineapple.
Oh, blood, I thought my number was on that one.
What, on the pineapple?
Well!
No, I was just repeating it.
Oh, I see, right. Oh, that's the banana then. Next, the raspberry. Honest looking thing, isn't it? You, Mr. Tin Peach.
Thompson.
Mr. Thompson. Come me with that raspberry and come on, be as vicious as you like with it.
No.
Why not?
You'll shoot me.
I won't.
Well, you shot Mr. Harrison.
That was self-defense. Come on, I promise I won't shoot you.
You promise you tell us about pointed sticks?
Shut up! No! Brandish that raspberry. Come on, be as vicious as you like with it. Come on.
Now, throw the gun away.
I haven't got a gun.
Oh, yes, you have.
I haven't!
You have! You shot Mr. Harrison with it!
Oh, that gun.
Throw it away!
Alright. How did you defend yourself against a raspberry without a gun?
You were gonna shoot me!
I wasn't! Come on! Come on, you worm! You miserable little man! Come at me then! Come on, do your worst, you worm! If anyone ever attacks you with a raspberry, simply pull the lever and the 16-ton weight will drop on his head. I learned that in Malaya.
Suppose you haven't got the 16-ton weight.
Well, that's planning, isn't it? Forethought.
Well, how many 16-ton weights are there?
Look, smarty pants. The 16-ton weight is just one way. Just one way of killing the raspberry killer. There are millions of others.
Like what?
Shoot him.
Well, supposing you haven't got a gun or a 16.
All right, clever dick! All right, clever dick! You two!
with raspberries. They are all basket each. Come on, cover me, women.
No gun?
No.
No 16-ton weight?
No.
No pointed stick?
Shut up.
No rocks up in the ceiling?
No.
You won't kill us?
I won't kill you.
Promise?
I promise I won't kill you. Now, you're going to attack me.
All right.
Right, now don't rush me this time. I'm going to turn me back so you can stalk me, right? Come up as quietly as you can. Right, close up behind me. Then, in with the raspberries, right? Start moving. Now, the first thing to do when you're being stalked by an ugly mob with raspberries is to release the dagger. The great advantage of the tiger in unarmed combat is that it not only eats the raspberry-laden foe, but also the raspberries. The tiger, however, does not relish the peach. The peach assailant should be attacked with a crocodile. Right, now the rest of you, I know you're there, lurking under the floorboards with your damsons and your prunes, hiding behind the wall bars with your quinces. Well, I'm ready for you. I've wired myself up to 200 tons of jelly night. And if any of you so much as tries anything, we'll all go up together. I warned you! I warned you, right? That's it!
Say, have I shown you my last operation?